special Halloween edition of
Discovery Highlights.
So much has been going on here at Discovery, it's almost scary.
It's a fright.
Conferences were a huge success.
That's right. Mrs. Bruin in the office reports that 7th, 8th, and 9th grade averaged an 85% turnout.
The 9th graders met in the cafeteria.
The 7th and 8th grade gathered in the gyms.
After all the conferences were complete, it was time for the annual running of the teachers and their chairs.
Here's what it looked like.
Wash away with my sticky fingers.
The first dance went well as students got together for fun and activities.
Here are some of the scenes the Discovery Highlights camera captured.
Oh,
Casey McCoy, who has a special guest.
Take it away, Casey.
Thanks, Whitney and Quinn. Jamie Piepenberg not only has been a reporter on Discovery Highlights, but she is also a top cross-country runner for the Alexandria Cardinals. It's great to have you back with us.
Thanks, I'm glad I could join you.
According to the Minneapolis Tribune, you have been ranked second in the entire state for most of the season.
That is correct.
About how many miles do you train each day?
Probably 5 to 7 miles.
How do you prepare for a race?
The night before, I eat pasta, and the morning of the race, I eat French toast. And right before the race, I'll do a short warm-up run and some stretching.
We have some video of the section race. Can you walk us through, or should I say run us through, what we'll be looking at?
I'd be glad to.
The individual women's champion this year with a time of 14:26.49, a freshman from Alexandria, Jamie Piepenberg. Our top 10 individual runners who will compete at the state meet at St. Olaf on Saturday, November 1st.
That was great and congratulations.
Thank you.
So what's next?
The state championship meet at St. Olaf College in Northfield on Saturday.
Well, good luck with that.
Thanks.
Go Cards!
Go Cards!
That's it from the sports desk. Now back to Quinn and Whitney.
All of us at Discovery Highlights appreciate music.
Yes, most of us sing and play one or more instruments.
Lauren Chum got very involved during a recent flute clinic.
Let's see how that went.
Thanks, Quinn and Whitney. Recently, flute players from around District 206 gathered at Discovery for a clinic.
Fun.
The instructor had a lot to share with us, and he even threw in a little humor.
It's comfortable to keep the flute here, right? It's less comfortable to keep it here. So as we bring the flute up, we go like this. Ooh, shiny thing. Because under all of it, we are flutists. So we bring the flute up and we turn the head like this.
Being chosen to demonstrate was a little unnerving, but I managed to play and learn some at the same time.
But we're gonna keep our head in position, so we're gonna do this. So go ahead, good. Now we're gonna do that one more time, keep it. I'm gonna stand up. And put the flute up like you're gonna play. Now play, breathe in nice and big, and you're gonna breathe in here, breathe in. Nice and big, 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 big. And blow. Now play our whole scale, breathe in nice and big and play.
That's all I have, Quinn and Whitney. Now back to you.
National elections are just around the corner.
That's right, rock the vote.
We sent Spencer Brand out for some locker talk to see who Discovery students like in the race.
I'm Spencer Brandon, and I'm here with Locker Talk. And the question is today, who is going to win the presidential election? I'm here with Josie and Becca. And who do you guys think is going to win the election?
McCain.
Yeah,
McCain. Hi, I'm here with Jake and Colby. And the question is, who do you think is going to win the election?
I think Obama is going to win.
Definitely Bill Clinton.
I'm Darian Bowman, and I think Jonathan McCain is going to win the election.
Yeah!
I'm James Himes, and I think Obama is going to win the presidential election because he is awesome.
I'm Gideon Halsell, and I think John McCain is going to win the election.
Hi, I'm Gideon Halsell, and I think McCain is going to win the presidential election.
I'm Christian, and I think Obama's going to win. First black president, yeah.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Eckhoff, and I just really don't know which way this is going to go this year. I'm anxious to sit home on Tuesday night and look at the results. I'm kind of thinking it's going to go Obama's way, but I'm not sure. It's going to be exciting. It's good. We're going to make history either way. So.
I'm Alyssa.
I'm Bianca.
And I think John McCain is gonna win.
Me too.
Hi, I'm Bryce, and I'm undecided who I want to win the presidential election.
We don't normally think of science as being all wet, but
it seemed that way when scuba diver Jeff Bruzik visited Mr. Halstead's first period ninth grade science class.
There's no reason to be scared of sharks because they're not attracted to humans, right? You know, all these shows, the big jaws, you know. Jaws almost bankrupt the diving industry because people are so scared. I know people when I teach them today, they're scared of getting bit by a shark in the legs. You know, they don't have them. But they're just not attracted to human blood. So you can cut yourself and the sharks are not attracted. But, you know, I've been on dives where they like drop like fish. And, you know, I got tapes where they, you know, they just start dumping the fish on. The sharks just come, just rolling over the reefs. And they would like grab and you roll the sharks over and pep their tummies. And, you know, they're very docile. I mean, they're really a pretty nice creature. I mean, you don't do that to a great white, you know, because a great white would hate
you. You know, it hasn't been all that spooky around here, considering it's All Hallows Eve.
Yes, I... What did you say?
I said, it hasn't been all that spooky around here, considering it's Halloween.
Right, but I thought you said, well, never mind.
What's wrong with you?
You look like a witch!
That's real nice.
Hold on, I have a mirror.
Huh. But that brings us to the end of another Discovery Highlights.